Hello, my friends. I'm Kyle. Welcome back to your home for real and comprehensible English, Pensando Inglés, where I bring you real and comprehensible English. And today, I'm going to bring you real and comprehensible native English in the form of something that is very important to understand these days. Memes, or like you guys say, memes, okay? Today, I'm going to look at some memes and we are going to talk about why they are funny, okay? So this is a good way to practice your English because you are going to learn vocabulary and you might just laugh, okay? So guys, I want you to tell me down in the comments below after this video, which one was your favorite? All right guys, here we go. First meme. Right here, when you open a snack and your girlfriend suddenly starts paying attention. So maybe a couple of you guys don't know what snack means. Snack is food like potato chips or maybe some cookies. It's not a meal. It's not like a whole dinner. It's something you eat when you're just a little bit hungry, maybe popcorn while you're watching TV or a candy bar. Okay, something little. So as you can see with the little shark here, he's like, I want that, okay? And okay, guys, if you have a girlfriend or a wife, I think you can relate to this meme, okay? I remember when my wife and I were just dating, there was one time in my house, I was gonna go make myself something to eat. I was a little bit hungry, so I wanted a snack. I asked her, hey, are you hungry? Would you like something? No tengo hambre. So I go in the kitchen, I make myself a sandwich, okay? It's a peanut butter sandwich because I love peanut butter sandwiches. I don't eat them much, but when I do, I love them. Nothing but bread and peanut butter and a glass of milk. That's my favorite snack. Anyway, I made the perfect peanut butter sandwich. I came back, sat down on the couch. She looked at me like this shark and she said, ¿Qué tienes? And I knew what she wanted. She wanted a bite of my sandwich. So then we shared my sandwich that I made for myself when she was not hungry. Okay? That's why that's a good meme, because girlfriends will steal your food. It's what they do. This is a good one too, guys. Tomorrow I'm going to get up and work out at 6 a.m. Okay, we all say that, all right? We're gonna go to the gym early in the morning. And it says me at 9 a.m. So as you can see by that lazy little guy, he did not get up at 6 like he said he was. Okay, I think you really gotta build up discipline if you're gonna try and go early in the morning to the gym, okay? And I think we've all been in the situation where our alarm goes off at 6 a.m. or 5 a.m. and we hit snooze or we turn it off, right? So I think we can all relate to that guy. He did not get up and he did not go work out. Well, this is a good one, guys. In case you think that you are working under pressure. Okay, so this means in case you think that at your job, your boss wants a lot from you, there's a lot of pressure, your boss always says, did you get it done yet? You better do it right, do a good job. Okay, well this guy in the black coat is Kim Jong-un, which is a dictator in North Korea. And the point of this is that if his people don't do what he wants, he will have them killed. So imagine the pressure that the guy that's doing the little job on the computer is feeling, okay? He cannot mess up. So next time you are at work and you think your boss is putting a lot of pressure on you, think about this guy trying to work for Kim Jong-un. Okay guys, here we go. So a shooting star is like you see a star in the sky and it goes shh, okay? You see it fly. Shh. It could be a meteor, it could be just a comet or an asteroid, but it looks like that. And we have a thing where if you see a shooting star, you have to make a wish. Ooh, I wish I had $1 million. Ooh, I wish I would find somebody I truly love, okay? And I think that might come from the movie Pinocchio. I think that's where that came from. Because there was a song in there that said, when you wish upon a star. So he says, ooh, cool, a shooting star. Then he makes a wish. I wish my salary raises would be higher than inflation. So salary is the money that your job pays you, and inflation is when prices for everything go up. So a big problem that a lot of people are facing in a lot of different places, some countries have already been destroyed by inflation, but right now it's a trending topic here in the US because salaries, what businesses are paying, are not going up. However, the cost of food is going way up, the cost of gas is up, okay? So he says, I wish my job would pay me more and inflation would go down. And then you could see the shooting star says, ooh, nope, can't help you there, buddy. Sorry, not gonna happen. And the joke of this meme is that the government is so stupid that that's a dumb wish and it can't be made, okay? Because they're gonna keep on screwing up the economy and salaries will not raise higher than inflation. But we can hope. Oh, this is a good one too, guys. You see the lady, she's at the doctor's office. Doctor says, hello, why are you here today? And me, I say, I don't want to go to work. All right, guys. Have you done this before? Be honest. Tell me in the comments. Have you went to the doctor so that you did not have to go to work? I'm going to be honest with you guys. I have. So, I don't know how it is at your job, but at my job and a lot of jobs, if you call off, you say, hey, boss, I can't come in today. I'm sick. Estoy enfermo. Yeah, you've done it before, I bet. So, the thing is, you can't just call and say that or else you'll get in trouble at work. You have to actually go to the doctor and get a note. Tell the doctor I need a note for work. They'll write you a note that says, so-and-so, Kyle, was in my care today. He can go back to work tomorrow. And when you take that, you say, hey boss, I was really sick yesterday, but I'm good now. Okay, you take it to your boss and you can't get in trouble. So a lot of times when people want a day off, they'll go to the doctor's office super early in the morning, right when they open up, get a note, and then they get to enjoy the rest of the day. I've done it once or twice, guys. Okay, this is a good one too. This is from Breaking Bad, and that guy is a psychopath. He's a really bad guy. But anyway, it says, my boss meeting with management, super happy. And then it says, my boss meeting with direct reports. Okay, so by management, they mean the boss's boss, okay? So for example, the manager meeting with the owner of the business, okay? His boss. And by direct reports, they mean trabajadores, okay? The workers, the people who are under the manager. So what they're trying to say here is that when the boss is around his boss, he's, okay, sucking up, we call it, sucking up. Oh, you look good today, sir. Looking good, I like your haircut. Nice. Oh, yeah, how's the weather? Okay, he's in a super nice mood, kissing up or sucking up to the boss. But when the boss goes away, he's mean to the workers, okay? And a lot of managers have this problem where they think that they are higher up than their workers, so they treat them like they are less of a person. And I don't like that at all. If I ever have my own business that's making money and I have people working with me, I want to treat them very well. I want them to respect me so they will work hard. My business will make money and I will be able to give them good money too. So that's a win-win. A lot of managers don't act that way. But when their boss comes around, hey sir, yeah, everything's great here. We're doing a good job, right guys? And then they want to pretend that they're your friend when the big boss is around. I've seen this happen. Guys, does your boss act like that when their boss is around? Okay. This one's pretty funny too. Okay, so here it says, me selecting a profile picture. And then it says a picture of me 10 years ago before I gave up. Okay, so you see the guy's mamadito, tiene abdominales marcados, he's got a six pack, he's got big muscles. So the joke here is a lot of times people who are a little older, sometimes they pick a profile picture for their Facebook, Instagram, whatever, their dating profile, okay, on a dating application. But instead of just taking a recent picture or foto actual like this, you know, hey, this is what I look like today, right? Click, that's my photo. No, they go pick a picture from 10 years ago when they were hot, all right? When they were muscular, or when the women had real pretty hair and her skin looked nice, okay? And then you meet these people in real life and you're like, you are not that person from the picture. Then they say, oh no, that's me. Yeah, I've gained a little bit of weight. Or me a couple years ago. I've seen this before, guys. Oh, this one's funny too. We got Arnold Schwarzenegger here. So that paint on his face is called camouflage. And we put on camouflage when we want to blend in or disappear and not be seen, okay? So he says, when I'm out and I see somebody from high school. So he's saying, the meme is saying, that when I see somebody from high school, I try and hide. Okay? Try and hide. And I don't know why we do this as humans. Why don't we just say, oh, hey, buddy. Take care now. So there have been a couple times where I've seen somebody and I just wave or shake their hand real quick and keep moving like, oh, hey, cool, man, take care. But sometimes you just don't feel like talking to people. They were never really your friend. So you kind of just look away and out of the corner of your eye, you can see that they look away too because they don't want to talk either, okay? So that one's pretty funny. I think us who are a little bit older in our 30s, who have been outside of school for a while, we could probably probably relate to this one. Right, guys? Right? Tell me it's not just me, guys. Tell me I'm not just antisocial. Here's another good one. Modern supportive husband. You've got the guy with his camera, microphone, and his headphones. Okay? What does this mean, guys? If this is a supportive husband, what's he doing? He's taking his wife's Instagram pictures, okay? Those of you guys who are married and your wife likes to take cute pictures for her Instagram, you know what I mean. Amor, one more please. Oh no, 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 I don't like that one. One more, please, one more. Okay? My baby always wants one more. But I do it like this guy. Because I'm a modern supportive husband. But seriously, guys, she records me more than I record her because she helps me with the channel. So I'm happy to take pictures of my wife. But this is just funny that you guys maybe have seen pictures of Instagram boyfriends where it's a guy on the ground trying to take a cute picture for his girlfriend. Yeah, you've seen that. Uh-oh, this one, guys, I've been here. When you're sleeping and your alarm did not ring, 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 ring yet, but the amount of sleep you're getting is suspicious. Okay, so sometimes we'll wake up and all of a sudden we feel really well rested and it feels like we've been sleeping for 10 hours and we're like, my alarm didn't go off. What's going on here, guys? Like, did I miss my alarm? Did I forget to set it last night? So guys, this sometimes happens to me because when I get up in the morning before work, the sun is not up yet, okay? It's still dark outside. So sometimes I'll wake up and I can see just a little bit of light through my window, ventana, and I get super suspicious, like, wait a minute, did I oversleep? But sometimes it's a little bit lighter in the morning. So that's what that is. I never forget to set my alarm because I check it like 2-3 times before I go to bed. I obsess about it because I'm scared of this. I don't ever want to oversleep because that's not a good feeling. Then you have to rush to work, you're late, you have to tell them why. So I try my best to be punctual, and being punctual means that you try to be on time to things. You don't want to be late. Oh, guys, this one's sad. That's why they've got Michael Jordan crying in this meme. When you wake up and check your phone to see how much time left to sleep, but it's right before your alarm is supposed to ring. Guys, this happens to me all the time. Usually I have my alarm set for 4:30 in the morning because I like to get up and go to the gym before I go to work. So a lot of times I'll wake up and I'll look at my phone and it's like 4:27 or 4:29 even. I've woke up and it was literally 1 minute before my alarm clock and I was like, ugh. Because everybody knows that the best feeling in the world is when you wake up, you look at your phone, and you still have 2 more hours. Oh, que rico, guys, que rico. And you get to lay back down for 2 more hours. That's the best. I love it when I wake up and my phone says like 2 o'clock in the morning. Oh, it's the best. So good. Okay, and here's the last one, guys. Last one. When you come back to work on Monday, hey, how was your 48-hour break? So, guys, people don't say, how was your 48-hour break? They say, hey, how was your weekend? But I never really thought about this until I looked at this meme. A weekend is only 48 hours, okay? We work all week just to have 48 hours free. That's sad. So that's what they're trying to say here, is that it kind of sucks that we work so much and then we only get 48 hours off and everybody's like, oh, how was your weekend? Like it was some sort of big vacation, but it's really not. All right, guys, those were the memes for today to help you guys to improve your English. I'm proud of each and every one of you who has been on this journey with me, okay? It's my journey of helping, sharing my language, trying to grow this YouTube channel, your guys' journey of acquiring a new language, which, in my opinion, is one of the coolest, most valuable things that we can do. So thank you, guys. Thank you for sharing in this journey with me, this learning experience. I promise you guys that even if you learn a lot from these videos, I am learning just as much or more. So, my friends, muchísimas gracias por ver. Nos vemos pronto.